Hi everyone. Today I'd like to tell you a little bit about one of my favorite composers. His name is Camille Saint-Saens, and his name is right up here. It looks like Saint-Saens, but it's French, so it's pronounced Saint-Saens. He lived in the 1800s, and he wrote lots and lots of beautiful music. But one of the things that he was famous for was using instruments to bring to mind certain characters or certain scenes that maybe we would picture in our mind when he heard his music. One of the things he liked to do was he would use a xylophone to represent bones. Now, I have two examples of that for you today. First off, this is a glockenspiel. A xylophone looks like this, but it's much larger and it has wooden bars. So you can just imagine the sound of striking those big wooden bars, what sounds it might give you. And it definitely brings to mind bones when I hear it. Well, the first piece of music he wrote is from a collection of songs called Carnival of the Animals. And he wrote about all different kinds of animals. And he wrote one piece about fossils. And I love this because he has this artist who loved the song. He did this picture of a dinosaur fossil wandering through the city and terrorizing people. So this is a little bit of Fossils by Camille Saint-Saens. I bet you can hear the bones. There's the xylophone once more. Wondering, where is he? Where is the dinosaur? I'm sure he's coming back through town. I have an assistant today, you can see. Where is he? Oh, I think he's coming back. There's the xylophone again. And that's just a little bit of Fossils by Camille Saint-Saens. Well, he's also famous for writing another piece of music, and this one is called Dance Macabre, and it is about Halloween. So this is a perfect time to share it. So where he lived in France when he was growing up, people would tell these stories about Halloween, and they would say, oh, be careful, because at midnight on Halloween, these spooky things come out, and there will be bats, and there will be ghosts, and there might be skeletons. And so he thought, you know what? You want something scary, I'll write you a scary piece of music. And so he uses different instruments to represent all those spooky things that people think might come out at Halloween, even though it's just all made up. And so he uses violins, and those represent the bats. And then he uses clarinets, and those are these big, gray, scary moths. And then he has one sound for the ghost. But what I like best is he uses his xylophone for skeletons. And so when you listen to the piece of music, you can definitely hear when the skeletons come around. So when you go to your playlist and press Dance Macabre, you're gonna see a little video screen, and you're gonna see little tiny animated characters that take you through the song. It's called a listening map because it takes you through the whole song, and you can hear all those different sections. So I think you're really gonna enjoy that this week. That's your listening map for Dance Macabre. It's down in the bottom on your playlist. Also on the playlist, I put a couple other Halloween sing-alongs I thought you'd have fun with. After you go through your playlist for Dance Macabre, I'd like you to try to think of an instrument that brings something else to mind. Maybe when you hear a saxophone, you see something in your mind, or when you hear drums, or when you hear a flute, or maybe when you hear a trumpet, might bring a picture to your mind. If you can associate another instrument with a place or a thing, I would love to hear about it. Leave me a note, let me know all about it. But have a great week, have fun on Halloween, stay safe, and I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.